गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम अगेन टू द रिवीव टू दिस क्लासेस। इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट हाउ द केमिकल रिएक्शन ऑकर्स। वी हैव सीन दैट वन ऑफ द एलिमेंट लूज गेन और शेयर सम नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स विद ईच अदर एंड दे फॉर्म अ न्यू सब्सटेंस एंड दैट इज कॉल्ड एज कंपाउंड। That process of losing, gaining or sharing of electron is called as chemical reaction. The new substance which is obtained at the end of the reaction will have the different chemical property than the substances which are reacting with each other, that we know, I think. Now here in our chapter the topic is how to represent this chemical reaction in the form of chemical equation. To describe the reaction, we have some symbolical forms by which we can represent the reaction in some simpler method, means equation form. For example, if I write magnesium reacts with oxygen, it's a very old experiment. Magnesium strip is burnt in presence of oxygen. So what happens? Magnesium reacts with oxygen and it forms magnesium oxide. So this is what the representation of chemical reaction. We are not writing the word forms, we are writing just the names of the substances which are taking part in the reaction and the name of the substance which is forming at the end of the reaction. I think you know that before doing this experiment particularly, magnesium strip is what makes smoother. Before doing this experiment, we have to remove the layer of magnesium carbonate found on this. Before burning the chemical, burning magnesium ribbon in presence of oxygen, we have to remove the layer of magnesium carbonate which is naturally formed over the magnesium strip, and then only we can start the reaction. Because we need magnesium to react with oxygen, not magnesium carbonate. But there is a thin layer of magnesium carbonate is there. So with the help of clothes, just we have to remove the layer of magnesium carbonate from the magnesium strip. Okay. The topic is now how we can represent this reaction, this equation in the form of symbols. So we have to follow many rules to represent the symbols. First rule. The topic for today is how to write chemical equations. Number of points to be taken care while writing the chemical equations. Step by step. Let me take you the introduction about the reactant. What do you mean by reactants? Reactants means the substances taking part in chemical reaction. The substances which are taking part in the chemical reaction are called as reactants. Just like magnesium and oxygen are the reactants. And the substance which forms at the end of the reaction is called as product. So what do you mean by product? The substances, products. The substances formed at the end of the reaction are called as products. Just like we have seen that magnesium oxide is the final product. So the substances which are taking part in the reaction are called as reactants. Substances which are formed at the end of the reaction is called as products. So chemical equation always represented by this way. Reactants always written on the left hand side. It gives to, so the arrow should be done. So this represents gives to product. So this is a simple format of any chemical equation. Now reactants. Always, first step to remember, electrons are always represented in its molecular form. In its molecular form, yesterday we discussed it. Molecules, not the atomic form. We have to represent all the reactants, not only reactants, you can write all the reactants and products are always represented in its molecular form. Say, magnesium reacts with oxygen. So, magnesium molecular symbol is Mg. Its atom itself behaves as a molecule. Reacts with oxygen. Reacts with oxygen. You can first write like this. Magnesium reacts with oxygen to form magnesium oxide. These two are reactants, this is product. So magnesium, so you can write Mg, symbolical form, molecular form, plus oxygen. So the molecular form of oxygen is O2. And the molecular formula of magnesium oxide is MgO. So this way you can represent the molecular forms of the reactants and products. So it is compulsory to show that all the reactants and products should be represented in their molecular format, not the atomic format. Okay, so we know that the formula for magnesium oxide is MgO, so we cannot write like this, Mg plus O gives to MgO. No, it is O2 always, because this is its molecular form. Okay, so the first rule to remember, all the reactants and products are always represented in their molecular form. Along with it, the second thing that we have to represent show their physical state. There means of reactants and products. So we have to represent the physical state of reactants and products. Physical state means like this, for example, Mg. So Mg is in which form you have taken in the reaction? Magnesium ribbon is taken in the form of solid. So Mg in terms of solid. So if you are taking solid substance, you can say S. You can write S in the bracket like this. Reacts with oxygen. So oxygen O2, molecular form. And it is always in the gaseous state. So for that you have G. And it forms magnesium oxide, actually the powder form. Powder means again solid state. So you can say S for that again. So this way you can represent the physical states. So for solid, it is S. For liquid, it is L, symbols for physical state. For gaseous state, it is small g. For aqueous solution, aqueous solution means when some soluble substance is dissolved in water, just like the salt, common salt dissolved in water. So such type of solution is aqueous solution. So for that we have symbol AQ, aqueous solution. For precipitates, sometimes the precipitates are formed at the end of reaction. So precipitates means solid substance actually. Sometimes you are taking two or more substance in the liquid state or aqueous solution state, but the product will be in the solid state. Or sometimes the precipitate formation means what? The precipitate means a lightweight solid. Lightweight solid which are floating on the solution. They are not at the bottom solids, but they are the lightweight solids, so they can float on the water. So such type of precipitates sometimes shown by this type of symbol. This is symbol for precipitation. Precipitates, insoluble lightweight solids formed on the product side. So So those type of precipitates are always represented by this lower downward arrow, but updated symbol for precipitate is S, because after all it is solid. Today in most of the books precipitates represented by S, but this symbol, if you see, I am giving you the information, because if somehow in some of the book if you find this type of arrow, so this type of arrow means solid. That's all. So these are some symbols for physical shape. For solid you can represent S, for liquid L, for gases G, for aqueous solution AQ, for precipitates this is down. Now sometimes, see, as we discussed yesterday, that chemical reaction is not the easy process. Whenever some chemical reaction occurs, some chemical factors to be provided. Sometimes some temperature required, sometimes some pressure required, light required, energy required. So to perform the task, to perform the chemical reaction, whatever the chemical factors required, that you have to mention in the chemical equation. So third point to be considered while writing the equation is mention important chemical factors to be provided during chemical reaction. Let me give you one best example to understand this. When nitrogen reacts with hydrogen, nitrogen reacts with hydrogen, it forms ammonia. It's very easy to write these things, it's very easy to understand. But the activity, to perform the activity, is a very difficult task. Nitrogen means N2. Hydrogen chemical formula, molecular formula H2, it forms ammonia NH3. Let me give you some important factors to be provided. This, first of all, this reaction occurs at 773 Kelvin temperature nearly. It required at least 150 bar pressure, it's atmospheric pressure. 1 bar means 1 atmospheric pressure, 150 bar means 150 times more pressure required inside the closed vessel. Then only these two can combine and they form ammonia gas. It is required some substances which makes the reaction faster. The process is actually very slow. So to make the reaction faster, we have to add some substances. The substances which are used in the chemical reaction, but they are not taking part in the reaction, they are just used to boost up the reaction, make the reaction faster, are called as catalyst. I think you know it. What do you mean by catalyst? Catalyst means the substances which are used in the chemical reaction, but not taking part. They are just used to boost up the reaction, are called as catalyst. So here, nickel or platinum is used at a catalyst, as a catalyst. In presence of this type of granule, the small pieces of nickel or platinum is used in this reaction. So these will help the reaction to occur faster. So such type of substance also to be added. Sometimes the catalyst which are used to make the reaction faster are non-reactive. The platinum is non-reactive catalyst. So to make it activated, because once the catalyst get activated, the reaction becomes faster. So to make the catalyst activated, we have to use some promotionals. Promotional substances. promotional substances means what? The substances which are activating the catalyst. For example, aluminium oxide, Al2O3, aluminium oxide is here used as a promotional substances which makes the catalyst activated and catalyst boost up the reaction. See how much care we are taking during the reaction. So all these are the factors to be provided in this particular reaction. So in such all chemical reactions, some factors are always to be required, always to be provided, and that important chemical factors we have to mention on the upper or the lower side of arrow. So third point is mention all the chemical factors which are important for occurring the chemical reaction on the upper or the lower side of arrow. Sometimes same reaction, for example, this is one of the closed vessel in which we are taking nitrogen and hydrogen gas. We are providing required temperature, we are providing pressure, we are providing catalyst and all the factors you are providing. So the chemical reaction starts. So initially in your vessel, there is only two substances you have taken, nitrogen and hydrogen, they are the reactants. Okay. As the chemical process starts, slowly ammonia also present in your vessel because it starts to form. As the amount of ammonia, amount word here in chemistry is replaced by concentration. Is replaced by concentration. So as the concentration of ammonia increases, what happened? As the concentration of ammonia increases, the reaction again starts backward. Means the ammonia which is formed by joining these two is again broken. And again it forms nitrogen and hydrogen. Okay. Initially you have taken nitrogen and hydrogen. So N and H reacts with each other and they form ammonia. As the concentration means amount here in chemistry replaced by concentration. So as the concentration of ammonia increases, again it breaks into nitrogen and hydrogen. Okay, so this type of reaction in which reaction goes forward as well as backward, such type of reactions are called as reversible reactions. See, for example, hydrogen reacts with oxygen, so it gives H2O, water, cold reaction. So whenever the hydrogen reacts with oxygen, it forms H2O, water. But water does not break into H2O2 under the same circumstances. So this reaction is not coming back. Such type of reaction which is not again occurring in backward direction are called as irreversible reaction. So irreversible reactions can be shown by this arrow, but some are the reversible reactions. So irreversible irreversible reaction shown by this arrow, but reversible reaction shown by this type of arrow. This means what? The reaction is occurring in both the directions. Okay, so these are some important factors to be understood. Last point, but the most important point, that whenever you represent the chemical equation, you are showing the physical state, you are showing the reactants and products in its molecular formula, you are showing all the important chemical factors, you are taking care of arrow also, that which type of arrow should be mentioned. But at the end, the equation must be balanced. Equation must be balanced with what? For example, magnesium reacts with oxygen, so it forms magnesium oxide. Okay, so when we write this equation, Mg plus O2 gives to MgO, so So look at this. How many atoms of Mg here? One. So on the right hand side, there must be only one atom of Mg. Is it there? Yes. Because how many atoms of Mg here? One. In the top. Now how many atoms of O you can see here? Two. Represent the number of atoms. So two atoms of O is here. But if you see on the right hand side, it is only one atom of oxygen. So where this one more atom of O goes? Is it destroyed? No, if you remember the law of conservation of mass or law of conservation of atom, that atom cannot be destroyed, cannot be created. Total number of atoms on the left hand side of reaction, means on the reactant side, should be same as the total number of atoms on the right hand side. So we have to make it balanced. We have to make it balanced. So equation must be balanced. This is the last and the most important point to be represented. So our next topic will be about what, how we can make the equation balanced. So today we have seen how we can represent the chemical equation. Please refer it.